Hundreds of protesters gathered in the Iraqi capital Baghdad on Saturday to demand U.S. troops leave the country in accordance with a parliament vote earlier this year. "Get out before the missiles of the faithful ones push you out," read one of the banners at the demonstration, which took place near an entrance to the high-security green zone where the U.S. embassy and other foreign missions are located. Others carried signs bearing the logo of the Popular Mobilization Units, better known as Al-Hashd al-Shaabi, the local Iraqi anti-terrorism forces, the only viable force against Daesh in the country. These protests came days after Iraq's anti-terror Kata'ib Hezbollah group, a faction of the country's Hashd al-Shaabi, had warned that a tougher and stronger confrontation awaits U.S. forces should they defy a timetable set for their withdrawal from the Arab country. Kata'ib spokesman Mohammed Mohyi had stressed last week that the conditional ceasefire with foreign soldiers in Iraq should be taken seriously, as the limits and conditions set by the resistance will be followed by confrontation. The Kata'ib spokesman further urged the Iraqi government to preserve the country's sovereignty and control its land and sky. Otherwise, it will be accused of collaborating and colluding with the Americans. Iraq's Harakat al-Nujaba resistance group, another faction of Hashd al-Shaabi, also warned of a malicious American plot to disintegrate the country through a soft war combined with political and religious sedition. Nujaba Secretary General Sheikh Akram al-Kaabi declared then that the United States had assassinated top Iranian anti-terror commander Lieutenant General Qasem Soleimani and the Popular Mobilization Forces second-in-command Abu Mahdi al-Muhandis in a bid to change the political security equation in Iraq. But the scheme was foiled by the nation's vigilance, and coming up next will be either withdrawal or direct confrontations. Welcome to the Middle East Stream. I'm Marwa Osman.